And right now, 7 Eyewitness News reporter Jeff Slauson is live for us with Siobhan O'Connor. She was one of the whistleblowers who Charlie's been speaking to throughout all of this. Good morning, Jeff.
Yeah, good morning to you both. Obviously a very monumental day. Siobhan and I were actually just saying how enormous this actually is. Now, Siobhan, thank you so much for waking up with us this morning. Did you ever see us getting to this point when you first had approached Charlie, you know, so long ago?
No, I never did. I could never have imagined that we would reach this point, and I certainly never wanted it to come to this, but given all that's been revealed through Charlie's reporting, through survivors coming forward and others, I knew that this was a necessity, and I'm so relieved that it's official after some false alarms and some false hopes. To think that it's official is such a relief.
Now, obviously, this is a big, big day, not just for parishioners, but for the diocese as a whole. So what do you think that this does mean going forward?
Well, I think this is the first necessary step towards true healing for our diocese. Every day that Bishop Malone remained here, obstinately refusing to resign, was very difficult, especially for survivors. So this is a huge step forward. It's the first of many steps, but it was so vital, and I think that this is going to be a great relief to the diocese as a whole.
First of many steps is the first step, obviously, trying to see into the future who that next bishop may be. What do you want to see out of that person?
Well, I really am praying that he will be a man of true integrity, someone who can come in here and work transparently and honestly and effectively with pastoral leadership as well. And I also hope that he will come in knowing that he has a very informed laity, people who are active and engaged, so that he and his staff will recognize that they can't continue as Bishop Malone had, that we will not accept that approach, that we are well past business as usual here in Buffalo.
And the hope obviously is that this promotes more clarity and more transparency within the diocese to the people that are within the diocese itself, right?
Absolutely. To the people of the diocese, to the survivors, to all those who've been waiting for an honest assessment of what's going on in our diocese. And unfortunately, the only way we've been able to find out what's going on is through Charlie's reporting, for which we're grateful, but it needs to come from the diocese now.
Changes, big, big changes coming just at the offices behind me. Still a lot of developments, obviously. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, Siobhan, and still a lot to come. For now, we are live in Buffalo. Jeff Slauson, 7 Eyewitness News.
Siobhan, the whistleblower who cracked this all open, and we should point out that she actually worked in the office with the bishop himself, overlooking that very road where she was standing when that first survivor came forward with his story of sex abuse.